The International Organization for Migration's Chief of Mission, Sanusi Tijan Sayej, has handed over the equipment received in the presence of the Uganda Civil Aviation Authority's Deputy General Olive Birungi Lumonya. The equipment is expected to enhance knowledge sharing in efforts for prevention and protection of migrants. The Chief of Mission in the International Organization for Migrants, Sanusi Tijan, says they are conducting digitalized approach for human trafficking awareness for the users at risk of human trafficking at Entebbe International Airport. He adds that the screens will be installed at the waiting, departure and arrival areas to display preventive measures for human trafficking in English, Luganda and Swahili languages.
I have some human trafficking case. They coordinate with us to see how we can bring back the traffic person to Uganda. And with that, I coordinate with my team and the office in Nairobi. They work together and then we assist in bringing back this trafficker, this trafficking person, and then the trafficking person also, we don't only bring them back, but also we make sure we do psychosocial, we do counseling, we reunite them with their family, and at some extent, we provide them with integration allowance to start up their lives again. Because you know, when someone is trafficked, you know the torture he or she might have gone through, coming back to be reunited back with the family or with the community is not an easy task.
According to Olive Birungi, the Deputy General, Uganda Civil Aviation Authority, the Uganda Civil Aviation Authority has played a big role to avoid human trafficking by working together with other stakeholders in the country. She adds that 30 girls were saved from trafficking and more than 200 people have been trained in the last 2 months on how to fight human trafficking at the airport.
Owing to the many interventions that we have put in place while working hand in hand with the various key stakeholders, operating at the airport, including immigration, state security agencies, handling agents and officials from the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, many potential human trafficking victims have actually been saved. Recall that I think a few months ago we had a meeting here, we had the minister and a number of people, and we had an opportunity to interact with over 30 girls that actually had been saved. They had travelled to Dubai and other states, and actually they were being abused.
Birungi further says the screens will be used to display information against human trafficking because ever since the lockdown ended, the number of people entering the country has increased to 5,000 per day, leading to the increase in the rate of human trafficking in the country.
We've held several trainings. CAA and the various stakeholders have benefited from several trainings that have been held. I think over 200 people in the last 6 months, or 300 have been trained, and we don't take that for granted. I take this opportunity to thank the International Organization for Migration, IOM, for the timely donation of the TV screens that we are going to receive. These will be used to run the digitized messages at the airport, which will also strengthen the prevention and protection aspects of migrants and potential migrants' knowledge on the risk of unsafe migration.
Johnson Namanya, the Commissioner of Citizenship and Passports, explains that measures have been put to avoid human trafficking, but the only option is locating and eliminating trafficking agents from the Ministry of Internal Affairs.
We have nothing to do with an agent, but they are so bright that they've been gathering these girls, preparing prior, even arranging medical, arranging Interpol letter, arranging passport ahead of time. And then they wait for somebody who already has a contract in UAE. So we are thinking that the best way is to regulate those agents the way we are dealing, URI is dealing with clearing agents.
Report by Godfrey Sembija for the news.